In the shadows of our planet, there's an extraordinary world where insects outnumber humans 200 million to one. By far the biggest animal family on Earth. They rule the skies, the watery underworld, and the rotting forest floor. They're bizarrely adapted. From horrifying mouth parts, strength in numbers, and killer camouflage. To a giant predator that rules them all, with the size and strength to prey on bats. This is the world of incredible insects. End of winter, Japan. A giant hornet queen awakes from a six-month slumber. At 5 centimeters long, she's the largest wasp on Earth. She has only one goal: to raise an army. She constructs a nest from wood pulp and spit to lay the eggs of her prized warriors. Every one a female. Her daughters are born armed and dangerous. A stinger over 6 millimeters long. Jaws strong enough to dismember prey. And wings designed for precision flying. Soon, the hive is over 600 strong. The larvae scrape their mandibles along the cell walls to signal their hunger. It is time for the hornets to hunt their favorite prey, honeybees. Scouts are dispatched. One reaches a beehive and marks it with pheromones, which guide the troops. They're after the larvae and honey. But first, they must destroy the bees. A single hornet can execute 40 honeybees in a minute. They rip the grubs from the comb. But the bees rally. They have evolved their own way of dealing with unwelcome wasps. First, they mob the intruder. By vibrating their flight muscles, the honeybees raise the collective temperature to over 40 degrees Celsius. The bees are more heat tolerant, and the intruder is literally cooked alive. Yet despite the bees' best efforts, they are no match for a hornet swarm. Within 3 hours, the massacre is over, and nearly 30,000 bees are dead. The hornets return to their nest, with enough food to feed the entire colony. Not least, the growing grubs. Hornets have mastered the military attack. But other bugs have adapted in different ways to find food. Even if it means getting wet. This is the diving beetle. Although it can fly, it prefers to swim. Its flat, round body helps it glide through the water like a torpedo. And a hardy exoskeleton protects it when it's on the hunt. Its back legs are covered in fine hairs and act like oars, which propel it forward. But most impressive is its ability to breathe underwater. The diving beetle shoves the tip of its abdomen out of the surface and pulls air into the cavity below its wings. This air bubble will act like a homemade scuba tank from which it can breathe. Once the oxygen supply is used up, the leftover gases are released, and the beetle returns to the surface for a refill. But why go through all this trouble? The answer is simple. Food. Down here, there's an all-you-can-eat buffet with little competition. And the diving beetle's favorite prey are juicy tadpoles. It can't see well at all, so the beetle simply grabs at anything that moves. It slices up its meal with a scissor-like mouth and starts to devour the tadpole alive. The diving beetle is not the only one to exploit these waters. While it may rule the aquatic underworld, another bug has evolved to patrol the surface. This is the miraculous water strider. Like a figure skater, the water strider has mastered the art of walking on water. The tips of its legs are shaped like oars, and while the middle legs paddle, the hind legs steer. At many a centimeter long, the water strider can move at over 1 meter per second. That's like an ice skater skating the length of 3 ice rinks in 1 second. Technically, water striders should sink as they're denser than water. Their long legs do help to distribute their body weight. But the true secret to this miracle is hidden at a microscopic level. Thousands of micro hairs cover its body and legs. And each hair is coated in a waterproof wax. These hairs trap air, which forms a bubble cushion against the surface of the water. As each leg pushes down, the air bubble pushes back, allowing the water strider to walk on water. Such miraculous legs require the utmost care, so grooming keeps its waterproof hairs in check. but don't let its small size and delicate touch fool you. The water strider is an accomplished predator. With its front legs, it picks up the vibrations of a struggling insect. But others also prey on drowning victims. It'll have to leave this one to the fish. Competition is stiff, but there's enough to go around. With special claws, he holds his prey in position and injects a cocktail of enzymes that liquefy the moth's gut before slurping up the nutritious meal. The water strider wades to shore to prepare for its next attack. A dangerous place for some, a nursery for others. This bizarre-looking creature is actually a dragonfly in the making. It's known as a nymph and is specially adapted to live underwater, with gills in its rectum and an onboard jet propulsion system. Some species will live as nymphs for up to 5 years, molting 15 times as they grow. To grow into an adult, this nymph must eat as much as it can. And it's a terrifying hunter. Behind this hinge lies a shocking surprise. It's hard to believe that something so adapted eventually takes to the air. But not all insect larvae live in water. One lives in one of the driest places on Earth. The 40-degree African savanna is the hunting ground for a lightning-fast predator. The antlion looks like a creature more at home in a Star Wars film. And it's perfectly adapted to rule this sandy inferno. Tiny hairs propel it through the sand, while a waxy exoskeleton slows dehydration. The antlion doesn't need to drink water. It gets all its liquids from its prey. It's the larva of a flying insect. But it still has to develop wings, eyes, and an anus. And to grow into a full-fledged adult, the antlion must eat. But first, it sets a hunting trap. Using its abdomen, it shovels through the sand in search of the perfect spot for an ambush. The antlion gradually bores into the earth, making the pit deeper and deeper. The steep sides are loose and unstable. Mm-hmm. sun showers knock its victim off balance. Its sickle-shaped jaws slam shut and inject paralyzing venom to finally subdue its prey. The jaws act like a straw through which the antlion feeds. Once the carcass is sucked dry, the empty vessel is discarded. And the antlion resets its trap, ready for the next victim. While the antlion's clever trap provides it with prey, it also offers protection from predators. Staying out of harm's way is an important driver in the evolution of insects and their defenses. And naturally, the most effective way of staying out of danger is not to be detected at all. Somewhere on this tree is the longest insect on the planet. The giant stick insect can grow to over 25 centimeters long. And to avoid being eaten, this dithering vegetarian has evolved an array of elaborate defenses. Her most powerful is camouflage. Sucker pads at the tips of her feet allow her to hang around, and even upside down, almost lifeless. Her exoskeleton bears a striking resemblance to bark, while her joints look like knots along a branch. Even her eyes are hard to find. The stick insect not only looks like a twig, she acts like one too, swaying in the wind. She consumes the entire leaf, leaving no half-chewed bit behind that might give away her position. The stick insect takes camouflage so seriously that even her feces looks like a stick. But when her clever camouflage doesn't quite cut it, she has another trick up her sleeve. Wings. This sudden flash of color is designed to startle predators. But the snake isn't perturbed. So the stick insect tries one more defense. Insect tear gas. It works. The stick insect goes to extreme lengths to cling to life. And so does this bug. She's stocking up her larder with bodies. This is the thread-waisted wasp. Her large eyes provide excellent color vision and allow her to spot prey from afar. For precision flying, she hooks her wings together like Velcro and targets her prey from the air. The wasp injects venom into the caterpillar, keeping it alive but completely paralyzed. But this preserved meal is not for her. She drags the deadweight dinner back to her underground nest, where her eggs are incubating, glued onto previously incapacitated prey. This wasp can carry caterpillars that weigh up to 10 times her own weight. Her forelegs are like rakes, uncovering the entrance to her nest. With strong jaws, she pulls the plug, and the caterpillar is dragged into the darkness. Completely paralyzed, it will stay alive and fresh in this tomb for weeks. And when the baby wasps are born, the caterpillar will be eaten alive. She covers her tracks. Only she will know where to find it again. While this wasp buries her victims underground, others go one step further to ensure a fresh meal for their offspring. This parasitoid wasp injects her eggs straight into the caterpillar. She lays up to 100 eggs in one shot, deep into the caterpillar's body. The soft insides of the caterpillar incubate the eggs, and once they hatch, the larvae will eat their way out. The growing wasp larvae control the caterpillar's nervous system and appetite, forcing it to consume 1.5 times more food than it normally would, until it's time to leave the host. They eat their way free and complete their transition into adulthood. But sadly, the mutilated caterpillar will never get to complete its own metamorphosis. The praying mantid is an expert huntsman. It combines incredible speed with a set of deadly weapons. Its front legs are spring-loaded and lined with hooks and spikes used to impale its prey. But the secret to the marksman's hunting success lies not only in its deadly forearms, but also in its incredibly sharp senses. Two thin antennae pick up even the faintest scent of prey. Its triangular head can turn almost full circle, giving it a supersized field of view, while 5 eyes allow it to detect movement up to 18 meters away. Its 2 larger eyes are made up of 10,000 light-sensitive structures. Essentially, each one a tiny eye with its own lens. Each tiny lens focuses light down to the optic nerve, where the full Super HD panoramic picture is created. These alien-like eyes don't have pupils. The black spots are an optical illusion. The mantid isn't just looking at you, it sees everything. Its weapons are loaded, and its senses are sharp. It's time to hunt. With incredible strength, the praying mantid tears its prey apart. After consuming every last bit, he cleans up before heading off to find dessert. The praying mantid is not the only killer patrolling the forest floor. While it may look funny, the assassin bug is more horror story than comedy. The bug has the ability to literally liquefy its prey. Its red color is not just for show, it's a warning to other predators. With antennae as long as its body, it seeks out its next meal. And its needle-like beak can inflict a painful sting. Once a tasty meal has been targeted, the assassin bug grabs hold. Tiny hairs on its legs offer a vice-like grip. Once it finds a soft spot, the proboscis goes to work. Within seconds, the prey is paralyzed and its insides begin to dissolve. The proboscis pierces the victim's gut, injecting a lethal cocktail of enzymes and digestive juices. This venomous saliva destroys everything in its path, turning the cells into soup. Once the liquid meal is ready, the assassin bug slurps it all up back through its deadly straw. Most bugs that feed this way have two separate tubes, one for injecting and one for sucking. But the assassin bug's beak acts as both syringe and siphon, which allows it to target large prey twice its own size. Africa is home to many deadly animals, both large and small. This river of jaws is made up of over 50 million ants, the largest ant colony in the world. These are driver ants. From the hunters and gatherers to the builders and architects, every single ant has its place in this super-organized super-organism. But the largest and scariest of them all are the soldiers. Standing over 3 centimeters tall, they guard the colony with their life and their enormous jaws. These powerful pincers can intimidate, crush, and tear apart anything that threatens the colony. Its jaws are so strong that they will maintain a vice-like grip even if its body is removed from its head. Local tribesmen even use the ants' decapitated heads as surgical staples to close up open wounds. To survive out here, the colony works together as one. They use their own bodies to build incredible structures. Columns to form the foundation for their nests. Living walls to protect their queen. And even bridges up to 12 meters long to cross water. And they do all of this in the dark. They're all blind. They communicate with pheromones, picked up with their super sensitive antennae. And the message is clear. It's time to feed. In just 24 hours, this black wave strips the life from an area as big as a football field. Up to 100,000 victims in one day. But not only the small fall prey to this deadly swarm. Driver ants will overpower birds and even weak mammals. Their victims are dismembered, transported, and consumed by the masses. They leave nothing behind. Once they've eaten everything in the area, it's time to move on and find new feeding grounds. Southern Africa may be home to some of the deadliest bugs around, but it's in the tropics that we find the true giants. An abundance of food and clever ways of avoiding predators have allowed a handful of bugs to reach incredible size, even though everyone starts off small. In this Indonesian jungle, a miracle is about to unfold right before your very eyes. This tiny egg, no bigger than a grain of rice, will give rise to one of the largest insects on the planet, the Atlas moth. But in order for him to reach gigantic proportions, he needs to eat. And for the first 6 weeks of his life, that is all he does. It's not long before he's too big for his own skin. His soft insides bulge, and his old bodysuit pops open to allow the caterpillar to grow. His large, fleshy spikes, coated in an itchy powder, help deter any hungry onlookers. He will shed his skin 4 times as he grows fatter and fatter. And nothing goes to waste. This glutton continues to binge eat until he's the size of a pork sausage. And then it's time for his makeover. The caterpillar starts to construct his own silk changing room. It's behind this silky curtain that the magic happens. While his outer skin hardens into a protective shell, the caterpillar's insides liquefy as his new body parts develop. It's a full body makeover. 1 month later, it's time for the big reveal. He pumps air and blood into his wings to expand and harden them. The wingspan extends to 30 centimeters. It truly is a mammoth moth. The ugly duckling is now a mosaic of color. And it's not just for show. The tips of the moth's wings resemble the face of a cobra. When threatened by predators, the Atlas moth will imitate this deadly snake by moving his wings back and forth. Despite this elaborate and miraculous transformation, the adult Atlas moth has little over a week to live. With no mouth, he is unable to feed, so all his energy goes into finding a mate. Even the biggest of insects will have to contribute to the circle of life. And with little strength left, our mammoth moth can't escape the dangers of the jungle floor. His time is up, and he becomes an integral part of the food chain. The tropical rainforest of Central America provides the perfect cover for our next giant. Amongst the decay of leaves and the remains of fallen trees, it's the grub of a Hercules beetle. This monstrous larva already weighs as much as an apple. And he's bulking up. He's lived underground for over a year, gorging himself on rotting wood, getting bigger and bigger. Tiny hairs all over his body help him haul his bulk through the wet soil, always searching for more food. Once he's the size of a bread roll, he disappears underground to begin an incredible transformation. 3 weeks later, the bulging grub has transformed into an impressive beetle. Its new limbs are hooked with claws. Its once soft flesh is now coated in indestructible armor, complete with a gigantic horn. This is the Hercules beetle. He's now almost 18 centimeters in length, and he's able to carry up to 850 times his own weight. That's the equivalent of a human lifting 9 elephants. Yet this giant is a strict vegetarian. This rotting fruit is a delicacy. But another male also has a sweet tooth. Their gigantic horns only have one purpose: to fight each other. And this feast is worth defending. The winner will be the first one to flip his opponent. The challenger doesn't stand a chance against our Hercules. Victorious, our heavyweight champion returns to his feast. But the intruder will have to try his luck elsewhere. This giant vegetarian may have size and strength on its side, but our next monster bug adds deadly venom to feast on something totally unexpected. The dark Amazon jungle is home to one of the world's scariest bugs. This is a centipede, an undulating wave of pointy clawed legs revealed this is not an insect. This species is carnivorous and venomous, but its sheer size is what sets it apart. Its last pair of extra long legs act like spiky pincers to grab anything that approaches from behind. But it's the front pair of modified legs that are lethal. two enormous hypodermic fangs filled with paralyzing venom. But the centipede is dwarfed by a bigger brother. This is the giant centipede. It can grow to the length of your forearm, which allows this heavyweight to capture prey twice its own size, even if it flies. When night falls in the Amazon jungle, things quickly go from tropical to terrifying. The giant centipede prepares to hunt. He's not interested in the beetles and cockroaches on the cave floor. There's a much larger meal on offer. It's pitch black, but the centipede is used to hunting in the dark. It's blind as a bat and uses its feelers to pick up the scent and movement of potential prey. The bats sense danger and take flight. But the giant centipede is waiting. He snags one out of mid-air. With the strength of a small snake, he wraps up his prey. His fangs sink in, quickly paralyzing the bat. The giant centipede shears off pieces of meat and devours the bat alive. It eats all the bat's flesh, doubling its own weight in the process. Over 400 million years of evolution have turned the giant centipede into a specialist cliff-hanging hunter. And there's no telling what prey it'll go after next. A world without insects is unimaginable. They are an essential link in the food chain, without which the web of life would collapse. Our collection of insects has many weird and wonderful abilities, from liquefying spit and strength in numbers, to expert weapons and full body makeovers. Some are specialist hunters, while others are attentive parents. They're masters of camouflage, and they are downright magnificent. The diversity of nature is alive and well in the incredible world of insects.